Lesson 2. In this lesson, you will learn how to ask a question when you want to ask about the location of something. Where is a house, for example? You will also learn how to describe the location of some objects and say here, there. You will learn also how to inflect the verb to be. So to say, I am, you are. Then you will learn how to pronounce the sounds G, sh, sh. And we will also have a look at the voiced and voiceless consonants and see how to recognize these. So let's get started. How would you say it is? This is from the first lesson. It is. To jest. If we want to say where, like where is something, then we will say gdzie, gdzie. At first it might sound difficult to pronounce, but let's see the sounds in the word gdzie. Let's split it up. So the first sound is g, g at the beginning, but then the three middle letters make the sound G, G. It is quite similar as in the word jeans in English, still a bit different, but it's G, G, G. And the final sound is E, E. So all those three sounds together, G, G, E, make the word gdzie. Gdzie. How would you ask a question? Where is it? Gdzie to jest? Where is my house? Gdzie jest mój dom? Where is a store? Gdzie jest sklep? If you now compare the first question, gdzie to jest, and the two next questions, gdzie jest mój dom, gdzie jest sklep, we can see slightly a different word order. So, like, gdzie to jest, having the jest at the end, compared to gdzie jest sklep, having the jest in the middle. Why is it so? In Polish, the word order is quite flexible, and you will notice that there is a tendency to hide very short words in the middle of the sentence. And here the very short word is to, to. So that's why gdzie to jest, we move the to into the middle, not to leave it at the end alone. Here in Polish is tutaj, tutaj, or in short, tu, tu. Both of these words are very common in Polish. It is here, would be to jest tutaj, or to jest tu. Is it here? Czy to jest tutaj? To jest tutaj? Czy to jest tu? To jest tu? Yes, it is here. Tak, to jest tutaj, to jest tu. Here is my house. Tutaj jest mój dom. Or tu jest mój dom. Here is a store. Tutaj jest sklep. Or tu jest sklep. There, or like over there, when pointing at something far away or talking about something that you can see far away, we have the word in Polish tam. Tam. It is there. would be To jest tam. What is there? Co tam jest? There is a house. Tam jest dom. Is there a house? Czy tam jest dom? Or tam jest dom? Is there a store? Czy tam jest sklep? Or tam jest sklep? I, when talking about myself, I, as a personal pronoun in Polish, is ja. Ja. Am, like I am, would be jestem. Jestem. And then when we combine those two and say I am, it will be ja jestem. Ja jestem. But you can also say in short jestem. That's all enough to say jestem. We already can recognize that we are talking about the first person singular. We will just keep this ja when we only want to emphasize the person. I am. Ja jestem. Normally, we can get rid of this ja and just say jestem. So how would you say I am here? Jestem tu. But if we want to emphasize I am here, then you will say ja jestem tu. Ja jestem tu, like me, not anybody else. Where am I? Would be gdzie ja jestem? Or gdzie jestem? You, when we talk about one person informally, then we will say ty. Ty. And are, when we talk about one person informally, like you are, then we will say jesteś. Jesteś. And this sh at the end is a similar sound as in the word sheep. Still a little bit different. Sh. Sh. Jesteś. So how would you combine those two? You are. Ty jesteś. Ty can be omitted here, and we just can say jesteś. We only keep this ty when we want to emphasize the person. Ty jesteś, you are. But normally we can get rid of that and just say jesteś. Jesteś. How would you say you are there? Jesteś tam. But when we emphasize you are there, will be ty jesteś tam. Ty jesteś tam. Are you there? Jesteś tam? Where are you? When we want to ask a question, would be gdzie jesteś? But when we are like irritated, where are you? And we will say gdzie ty jesteś? Gdzie ty jesteś? So how would we say I am here? Jestem tu. You are here. Jesteś tu. I am here and you are here. Ja jestem tu. I ty jesteś tu. Here we use these pronouns ja and ty because we kind of underline that I am here and also you are here. Ja jestem tu i ty jesteś tu. And if we want to say I am here and you are there, like I am here while you are there, here we focus on the contrast, that there is a difference in the location where we are, then we will say ja jestem tu, a ty jesteś tam. So here we use this word a between these two clauses. It is, in Polish is, to jest. What is it? Would be, co to jest? But also we can say, co to? In some short sentences, we might omit the verb jest. So simply, co to? Co to? Just pointing and asking, that would be really enough. We don't have to say jest. Co to jest or co to? How would you say this is a big store? To jest duży sklep. Or in short, to duży sklep. Who, like who is this? Who in Polish is kto? Kto? Who is this? Would be kto to jest? Or in short, kto to? Kto to? Who's there? For example, when somebody's knocking at the door, who's there? We will say kto tam? Kto tam? If you want to say I'm sorry for doing something, but also to say excuse me, we have one word for that in Polish, which is przepraszam. Przepraszam. A very important word, and I know it might be difficult to pronounce at the beginning. When we look closer to this word, we can identify sounds as p, sh, e, p, r, a, sh, a, m. Maybe the most difficult sound will be this sh, sh. We can hear it twice. So cz in the second part of the word is sh, sh. It's pronounced similarly as in the word sharp, sh, sh. Slightly harder than that, sh. But also rz will have the same sound if it's next to a voiceless consonant or at the end of the word. Przepraszam. Excuse me, who is this? Would be przepraszam, kto to jest? Excuse me, what is this? Przepraszam, co to jest? Excuse me, where is a store? Przepraszam, gdzie jest sklep? I'm sorry, the store is over there. Przepraszam, sklep jest tam. Good. Now let's summarize. Let's first go through all the new words that appeared in this lesson. Then let's talk about the pronunciation and the grammar. Gdzie? Gdzie? Tutaj. Tutaj. Tu. Tu. Tam. Tam. Kto? Kto? Ja. Ja. Jestem. Jestem. Ty. Ty. Jesteś. Jesteś. Przepraszam. Przepraszam. Let's now focus on the pronunciation and let's see what kind of sounds were introduced during this lesson. Let's listen to the sound, to the example, and what would be the approximate sound in an English word. G. G. Gdzie? Gdzie? So this G, G sound is kind of similar as in the word jeans. G. 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 Like in the word gdzie. Gdzie. G as in the English word good. G. Sh. Sh. Like in the word jesteś. Jesteś. It is close to the sound as in the English word sheep, but the Polish sh slightly softer. The next sound would be sh. Sh. As in the word przepraszam. Przepraszam. Although the first combination RZ is written differently, it is the same sound. Sh. Sh. As in the English word sharp, we can find a similar sound. Sh. Sh. Still, the Polish sh is a bit harder in the pronunciation. Then we have u. U. Like in the word tu. Tu. It is similar as in the word foot in English. Now let's look to the topic about the voiced and voiceless consonants. This is quite an important topic when we talk about the pronunciation in Polish. Why? You might notice that a voiced consonant is pronounced as a voiceless consonant. This, for example, happened with the word przepraszam. But now let's look closer. What is exactly this idea about that? A voiced consonant is a consonant that produces a vibration in the throat when we articulate the sound. And a voiceless consonant, on the contrary, does not produce any vibration. But let's see maybe an example just to get the idea. So here we have a pair of a voiced and a voiceless consonant. The b, the first sound, b, b, b. If you touch your throat when producing this sound, you will feel a vibration, b. But the other sound in the pair, p, 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 does not produce any vibration in the throat. So it's like b, p, b, p. If you test it out, you can feel the difference. And there are more pairs like that. We have a voiced consonant that has an equivalent of a voiceless consonant. Everything else, apart from the vibration, is similar when we produce these sounds. So the lips are similar, the tongue is similar, only the aspect of the vibration is the difference. So let's see the other pairs. D, t, d, t, d, t, if you are touching your neck, the throat part, you can feel or not feel the vibration. So you should feel when you produce d, but you shouldn't when you produce the t. Okay, let's see other pairs. G, k, g, k, g, k. Next one. V, f, v, f, v, f. Z, z, z. Z. Next one. J. Sh. J. Sh. J. Sh. Next one. J. Sh. J. Sh. J. Z, 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 g, ch, g, ch, g, ch, d, t, d, t, d, t, d. I know that some of these sounds, especially at the bottom, were maybe new and difficult to pronounce for you, but we will practice them throughout the course, so don't worry. Here it's more about getting the idea, understanding the idea, and seeing the difference between the voiced and voiceless consonants. Why is it so important to know the difference? Because sometimes the voiced consonant is pronounced as a voiceless consonant. This happens if a voiced consonant is at the end of the word. For example, in the word teraz, we don't say teraz, we just say teraz. So it loses this vibration at the end of the word. Another possibility, when a consonant is pronounced as voiceless, is when we have a voiced a consonant next to a voiceless consonant. Then they are like together voiceless. So in the word przepraszam, P is voiceless and Ż becomes voiceless. Sh, psh, przepraszam. But we will see more examples throughout the course, so don't worry if this is overwhelming at the moment. For now, just remember about the idea of having voiced and voiceless consonants. Let's also review the grammar part, which was introduced during this lesson. So I mentioned that the word order is quite flexible in Polish, and sometimes we move very short words to the middle of the sentence. For example, gdzie to jest? Where is it? But gdzie jest sklep? Where is the store? So we can see that the jest is located in different parts of the sentence. It is because this to in the first question was moved to the middle of the sentence, because this is the tendency to hide very short words, not to be at the end. Then in some short sentences, you might find out that the jest is omitted. This is happening in very short sentences. So you can say co to jest, or in short, co to, meaning what is this? This is the shortened version is mainly used in the informal language. And you can also omit the personal pronouns ja and ty, because we already have the inflected verb, which tells us what person is it referring to. We will keep the pronoun only when we want to emphasize the person. So you can say ja jestem, or in short, jestem, as I am. Ty jesteś, or in short, jesteś. Let's now have a dialogue at the end and try to listen and understand as much as possible. Then compare with the English translation.
Kto tam?
To ja.
Przepraszam, kto?
To ja, Monika.
Tak, to ty.
Well done. This is the end of lesson 2.